I'm going to show you a couple of key features here with the Clinic 360 solution. You know, one of them is going to be the Clinic 360 mobile app, and that's really where, you know, as a provider, you probably spend most of your time, you know, getting in there and managing your notes. And the other side of it is a web portal. So we're also going to take a look at the web portal, which could be used by administrative staff. As Bonnie was mentioning earlier there, there's some great reports in there. You know, or the provider themselves could still use the web portal to go in and review the notes as well. So, you know, first let's talk about the Clinic 360 mobile app. And, you know, it really gives you the freedom to dictate, you know, anywhere, anytime. You know, you can really do it all from there as far as creating your note, you know, picking your patient, creating your note, editing your note, reviewing it, signing off on it. It's really all built into the app here. So, you know, it's really kind of a one-stop shop as far as that goes. Everything is accessible for you there. And, you know, and because, you know, you do have the freedom to dictate anywhere and any time, you know, that just naturally is going to improve your productivity. It's going to improve your quality of patient care as far as, you know, you're not having to be tethered to the machine or the computer or the EMR. You know, you can have more, you know, face-to-face time with your patients there. And, you know, because everything is, you know, integrated with the EMR, everything is routed automatically, you know, that's really where it's also going to improve, you know, your billing time, your turnaround time for reimbursement. You know, you'll get reduced claim rejections, and, you know, it really is a complete solution here. So let's go ahead and take a look at just a couple of quick notes on the mobile app. You know, so it is going to work for Apple or Android, so you're really covered in either area there. You know, very simple, easy to use. We'll take a look at a few screenshots here in just a moment, and, you know, we'll go through a couple of workflows there. But, you know, like we were saying, you can really use it to create, review, and edit all of your notes, and then, you know, sign off on any notes as well. And, you know, it does have a real-time patient list. So just as, you know, a typical EMR would, you're going to be able to get in there, see your patients, see their demographics. You know, you can flip forward and backwards, you know, as far as a typical calendar, and you'll have your real-time, you know, patient list there as well. And then also another nice feature is, you know, as you're dictating, you can go back and review your previous notes, which, you know, it's hard to do nowadays with a lot of the EMR systems, you know, that we see. It's not as easy to go back and, you know, kind of read your previous note while dictating or, you know, working on your new one. So it's very, very handy to be able to go back there and see those previous notes. So let's go ahead and take a look. The next slide, we're going to have just a few screenshots that we're going to go through. We're going to talk about really those two main types of workflows that you're going to be, you know, going through on your mobile app here. So, you know, from the provider standpoint, you know, you're going to have a login and password. So you'd open your app, you'd log in. And these screenshots are kind of in the order here that you're going to be going. So you log in, you then be presented with your patient schedule along with all the demographics. And again, you can go, you know, forward and backwards, yesterday to, you know, tomorrow. You have, you know, the options there as well. You know, from there, you're basically, you know, just tapping on whichever patient, you know, you're wanting to create a note for. And the last three screenshots there, you can see, you know, you do have the ability to use templates as well. So, you know, aside from just the standard, you know, recorded dictation, you could also implement, you know, a normal physical exam, a review of systems into your note along with, you know, your recorded dictation. So very straightforward, very easy to use. You know, it just takes a couple of taps really to kind of get in there, open up your patient, and begin dictating. So that's one side of it. You know, the other side is, you know, after you've dictated, the notes come back, you know, it's been transcribed. You want to go in and review it, you know, make sure everything is okay, you know, do any editing, and then finally, you know, complete it with your e-signature and sign off on it. So that's what we're looking at here. And these screenshots are for the Apple app, but very similar, you know, to the Android, basically the same thing there. But, you know, here on the first screenshot, you can see kind of your different inboxes, whether it's waiting to be reviewed or still waiting to be typed, or, you know, in something you need to sign off on. You have some options there. And basically, you know, you would just tap on to whichever one, you know, you're looking for. Here in the next few slides, this is an example of going in box and reviewing anything that is, you know, waiting to be reviewed and completed. So that's the screenshots you can see here. You see the note there on the third screenshot. And then the last one gives you the option to go in there and edit it, or if everything is correct, you could just complete it and go to the next one. So very easy, very straightforward to use there. And as a provider, you could really spend, you know, all of your time, you know, just here with your mobile app, and it's really, you know, all that you would need to do. Another site I want to show you here, though, is I want to go ahead and show you the web portal. So again, this is great for administrators, or, you know, this is your other option as a provider to go in there and review and sign off on your notes and documents. So let me go ahead and switch over. All right, so, you know, once you log in, this is kind of your home screen there, the web portal. You know, you have a lot of useful things here. You can go through and change preferences, and, you know, you can get help, help desk support, and, you know, a lot of manuals, instructions are available here for you. You can also see, you know, a snapshot of your workflow. So over here on the right, you can see, you know, how many notes are out there sitting waiting to be reviewed or waiting to be signed and, you know, printed or coded. So you have a lot of, you know, options there as well. And we'll take a look at that in just a moment, but first I'm going to go ahead and show you the reporting section here. So we're going to go ahead and click on Reports, and it basically just brings us to this tab in Vision here is the reporting system. So, you know, here is just an example of some of the reports that, you know, come with the system here kind of out of the box. You know, anything that you do want to change or possibly create your own report, you could definitely do that here. Very flexible and powerful as far as the reporting features go. So anything you can think of as far as, you know, any kind of data you're looking to mine, anything you're trying to figure out with your reporting really could be, you know, created there. You would just let your project manager know and they could, you know, we could definitely get that done for you. But, you know, just a few examples of some reports here. I'll just scroll down a little bit. So you can just see, you know, everything from transcription production to, you know, turnaround time compliance. You know, really, they do have a good set of default reports here to look through. And I actually ran one ahead of time just to show you guys here. Let me go ahead and pull it up. So, you know, it's just going to create the report as a standard PDF document. But, you know, here we have an unsigned transcription summary. So, basically, you know, very nice to just easily have a report of, okay, these are the ones we need to go in there and sign off on. You see it lists them by provider, and then it goes ahead and lists, you know, the patient's name and demographics. So, you know exactly which note you need to open up there and get, you know, signed off on. So, you know, from the management and administrative point, very powerful, very useful reporting features here. And I think you guys will definitely love that feature of it. Now, going back to the provider, you know, if you do want to go in here and check out your you know, notes waiting to be reviewed, we could click here on the workflow tab, and you see here these are, again, are all the notes that are kind of waiting to be reviewed here, you know, and then you know, finally be signed off on. But anything you do want to change, if you do maybe want to go here and edit, it's real simple. You just find the patient, click on edit, and let's see. Let me try another option here. You know what, maybe they're having some trouble with the database here. It doesn't seem to be editing. Let me just try one more time. Nope. Looks like it is maybe going down here. So, you know what, this is a test database. There may be some other hands in here. Yeah, it looks like it's been closed out there. Let me go ahead and sign back in here one more time. We'll see if we can pull that back up. All right, here we go. So, we'll go back to the workflow tab. Just really quickly wanted to show you guys that edit feature. So we'll go here under the inbox. We'll go back here to edit. And then, you know, easily you can go in here, review the transcribed note, and then easily go in here and make any changes. And, you know, you could potentially use Dragon in here as well. If you have Dragon on your computer, you could definitely get in here and use Dragon to make these changes. As well, then, you know, just go ahead and save it and complete it when you're finished. So, you know, very, very easy to use, very, you know, really straightforward, but very powerful as well. So it's a nice web portal. So you have this along with a mobile app, and that's really, you know, going to be your two ways that you're going to get in there as the end user, whether it's the provider or, you know, the administrative staff to really go in here and manage and get a handle on everything, you know, Clinic 360.